We are looking at chapter number 3, which is current electricity. So resistors, we can arrange them in order of series or parallel. So resistors can be connected in series or parallel, or series or parallel together, that is combination of both the types between any two points. So we have already seen the series and parallel connections of resistor. Here we are going to talk about the results and more combinations. So series combination of resistors. Resistors are said to be connected in series between any two point if the same current, see this I is going to this resistor, and this only current is coming out. So same current is passing through R1, R2, R3 and Rn. So if the same current is flowing through each resistor, there is only one path available for the flow of current. So this figure, it shows R1 to Rn, and we know that the equivalent resistance is given by Rs given by R1 till Rn. So we write sigma 1 to n, and this is Ri, R sub I varies from 1 to n. So the equivalent resistance of the series combination of resistor is always greater than the greatest value of the resistor. So whichever is the greatest value, the equivalent resistor will be higher than the greatest one. So if n identical resistor, each of R are connected, you can replace R1, R2, R3, Rn by R. So this will be, if there are n identical resistor, the total resistance will be n into R. Parallel connection of resistors. So when these resistors are connected in parallel, that is, if they are between, they are connected such that they are between two points and there are more than one path available for flow of current. So the current I, it divides into I1, I2 till In, right? And the potential difference, that is point A, point B, the VA and VB, if these are potential, VB minus VA is identical for all these resistors, right? Potential difference remains the same. So here we have n resistors, say from R1 to Rn, and the equivalent resistance 1 by Rp, this is for parallel, is given by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 till 1 by Rn. And this is sigma I equal to 1 to n, 1 by Ri. 1 by Ri, R sub I, this I varies from 1 to n. So the equivalent resistance of a parallel combination of resistor is always smaller. It will be always smaller than the smallest value of resistor connected in parallel. So if any of these is smaller, smallest of all the resistor, the equivalent resistance will be even smaller than that. So if n identical resistor, they having resistance R, are connected in parallel, so equivalent resistance will be 1 by Rp will be 1 by R, 1 by R, 1 by R, add n times, so it will be n by R. So we have to revert it, we have to take the reciprocal to find Rp, that is R, equivalent resistance which are parallel. So this will be capital R by N. So this figure, the first figure we are taking, some current flows through resistors R1, R2 and R3. R1 is given as 10 ohm, R2 is given as 20 ohm and R3 is given as 30 ohm. And the battery voltage is equal to 10 volt, right? So we have to find out what will be the current. So see, let us first start with this point A. We have to find out the equivalent circuit, because this is not an equivalent circuit. We have to find either it is in parallel or either they are in series. So we have to find an equivalent circuit first. So here one end of this resistor is connected to point A and the other is end of the resistor R2. See, this R2 is connected to this point C. So A and C, in between this we have R1 and R2, and so the circuit can be reassembled, because this A and C can be combined, because these two can be combined. So A and C point can be combined, and if you see that this R1 becomes R1 and R2, these are parallel to each other. Similarly for the other end of the resistor R1, see this B. And this R2 and R3, these are connected to point B. See, this is the end which is connected to B. R1 is also connected to B. So what we can deduce is we can combine this B and D. So when we combine this B and D, in between this B and D we have R2 and R3. So these two are in parallel. From first discussion, R1 and R2 were in parallel. From second discussion, R2 and R3 are in parallel. That means R1 and R3 are also in parallel. So R1, R2, R3, they are in parallel. Okay. Now if say I current is passing, let us say that I1, I2 and I3 are the current through R1, R2 and R3. So what will be the current flowing? I1 will be equal to V by R1, right? Voltage is given as 10, R is our 10. So for the first one, it will be 10 by 10. Second will be 10 by 20, 20 is the resistance 2, 30 is the resistance 3, voltage remains the same. So these are the current R1, R2, R3 is passing through. An electric current 5 ampere is divided into 3 branches forming a parallel combination. So there is a parallel combination. The length of the wire in the 3 branches are in the composition. So L1, L2, L3, L1 is to L2 is to L3 is 2 is to 3 is to 4. See? And their radii are in the ratio or proportion 3 is to 4 is to 5. So one is 2L, the other is 3L, the third one will be 4L. Similarly, for radius it is given as 3, 4, 5. So one is 3R, the other is 4R, and the third one will be 5R. These are the ratio being given. We know that R is equal to rho L upon A. So these are the respective resistances, right? So R equal to rho L upon A. First of all, we'll use L1 and A1. So L1 is, we can use 2L, and A is, we know that for area we have to use pi R square, and this is the radii 3R. So we'll use pi into 3R whole square. So L will be 2L in the first case, and area will be pi 3R square. So we'll put it here. Similarly, R2 will put 3L and 4R square. For R3, we'll put 4L and pi into 5R square. Now the ratio of, the ratio can be easily found out. This is 2 by 9, this is 3 by 16, and this is 4 by 25. So R1 is to R2 is to R3 is 2 is to 9, 3 by 16 and 4 is to 25. We know that V equal to RI. Okay. So R, you can say R equal to V by I. So if resistance are in this ratio, what will be I? I will be in opposite ratio. So R is 2 by 9. So I1 is to R2, I2 is to I3 will be 9 is to 2, 16 is to 3 and 25 is to 4. So these will be the value. Okay. And we could just multiply them by a suitable number so that we can remove the denominator. So you can take the LCM of this and multiply it. And now the I1 can be found out. I1 is simply this V1 by this value, right? R rho L upon A you can find out. And this I2 can be also find out. And I3 can also be found out. We have various relationship between them because I and R ratio is known. And the when I and R ratio is known, you can just multiply this 54 and into 5 by 193 because this is the total, right? And this is the current you can obtain. Series and parallel connections of cells. So like the resistors, these cells also can be connected in series or parallel, or you can combine them, you know. In one circuit you can have parallel and series combination both. So when cells are in series, suppose we have two cells, say we have first having EMF E1, second having EMF E2, and the internal resistance of this cell is say R1 and this is R2. They are connected in series, that is the current passing through both of them are same. So an external resistance, this external resistance R is also connected across the connection. So we will apply the Kirchhoff rule. So if we say the current, because current will take this direction, right, and we will move in the ABCDA direction, means ABCDA. So when we go here, it is coming, see, it is from higher to lower. So we will get this E1 in negative. We are going from higher potentials to lower potentials, so we have to take negative. And because we are moving in opposite direction to the current, so this will be positive, right? I into R1. Then again, for the same reason, this will be minus E2. And we are move for this one, we are moving in the opposite direction of current, so we have to take plus I into R2. That is, there will be voltage up, not drop. And as we are moving in the opposite direction of this I into R, again this has to be IR, and this whole will be equal to zero. In a closed loop, the voltage or the potential difference between the same point, if you take a loop, it will be zero. So take E1 and E2 on this side, take I common, so I will be equal to E1 plus E2 by R1, R plus small r1 plus R2. So what we have got here is, this is the equivalent EMF and this is the equivalent resistance, internal resistance, and I is the current which is passing through the resistor. So this series combination of two cell, this act as a single cell. So if you combine two cells in series, the equivalent, you can assume it to be a single cell, E1 plus E2. And internal resistance, this has R1, this is R2. So you can also say that the equivalent resistance is R. So in this sense, E equivalent is equal to you can say E equivalent is equivalent EMF, and R equivalent is the equivalent resistance if you connect the cells in the series. But if the polarity of one of the cells is reversed, then the EMF will be E1 minus E2. But the equivalent resistance, internal resistance, will not change. It will be R1 plus R2 only. Means if you combine like this, this is E1, this is E2, the resultant will be E1 minus E2, okay, and the modulus of this. But resistance R1, R2, because resistance is already there, always there. For current, if current is passing, the resistance will be there itself. So R1 plus R2 will remain as whether you connect it like this or in this similar polarity or in opposite polarity. Now the cells, when we put it in parallel, so this is one cell, this is two cell, and this is, these are kept in parallel, and we have a outer resistance, right? So suppose we have two cells, this is having E1 and E2 are the EMFs, internal resistance is R1 and R2, the current is like this. See, if you see I is passing through like this, then I will divide into I1 and I2, and I1 will pass through this, I2 will pass through this. So we want to find the current which is flowing through this external resistor. So we'll apply the Kirchhoff rule easily, because we know that I will be equivalent to I1 plus I2, right? And this will be our first equation. Now we can apply the Kirchhoff second rule for two loops. First will be our C. This is A, D, and R, and C, and B, and first we'll take this E1, right? Means this will be our first loop, and then we have second loop, A, D, R, C, B. Now this loop we are going to take, this loop. So two loops we are going to take. So first we'll apply the Kirchhoff law to the first loop. So there will be, we are moving in the direction of current, okay? So this is, let us start from here. We are moving in the direction of current, so we'll be I into R voltage drop. Then we are coming here. I1 is, we are in the direction of current. So I1 R1 will be voltage drop. So minus I1 R1. For this, we had already taken this. And since we are going from negative to positive, there is increase in the potential. So it will be plus E1, and this will be equal to zero. Similarly, for the other one also, we'll find out the same scenario, but here we will take E2. And from this, if you see, if you take I1, if you want to find I1, we take all other things on the right hand side, we get I1 equal to E1 minus IR by R1. For the second one, we get I2 equal to, similarly, this is replaced by E2, IR by, this will be replaced by R2. So we have I1 and I2. Now, the first equation was what? I was equal to, this I is equal to I1 plus I2. So I was equal to I1 plus I2. Let us put I1 and I2 we just found on in the previous discussion. That means this I1 and this I2 we have to put. So when you put it here and just rearrange them, right? We just need to rearrange in order to find I. So I will be equal to, this will be the final reason. Fine. So it will be I equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2. We are just rearranging it. So what we get when we divide the numerator and denominator, we have this R1 plus R2. So we can just divide numerator and denominator by R1 plus R2. So we can divide this and we get this as the equivalent EMF R plus, and this is our equivalent resistance when they are in parallel. Please understand, we are talking about parallel. When the resistances are in parallel, that means you get 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 like this. So in the parallel combination of cells, it acts as a single cell whose EMF is given by this, E equivalent is given by this whole value. So it is E1 R1 plus E2 R2 by R1 plus R2. And what will be the internal resistance? Internal resistance is given by R1 R2 R1 plus R2. Because we know that R equivalent, 1 by R equivalent is simply 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. And you can take this, the ratio of this two equation, this equation, 3.11.8 and 3.11.9, and you can easily find out E by R. This is E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2. So if the EMFs of two cells are E1, E2, if you say that they are equal and R1, R2 are also R, we simply get E, this EMF equivalent will be equal to E, means total of this, and R equivalent will be simply R by 2. Okay, so we have joined, I'll just show you some more figure regarding this. And here what we have done, see, we have joined the positive terminal at point A, and similarly the, if you see the two negative plates at point B, so the current I1 and I2 flow through the positive terminal. But if the negative terminal of the second is connected to positive terminal to the first, right? This is a scenario, but I am just saying that we are just changing. I just want to reverse the polarity. Then we would still get E2 only, as we just have to put E2 equal to minus E2, right? Because the situation is like this. If you convert it like this, right? So only the EMF will be negative, because ultimately what we have done is we have followed the Kirchhoff rule, and if we just change the polarity, it will be according to that. So if there are n cells of EMF E1, E2 and EN, and internal resistance are R1 to Rn, their connection in parallel, the combination is equivalent to a single cell which has EMF which is equivalent, and internal resistance is R equivalent. So 1 by R equivalent is given by 1 by R, 1 by R2 till 1 by Rn. And if you have already seen that E equivalent by R equivalent is given by E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2, and I was given by sigma EI by Ri 1 plus R sigma 1 by Ri. I varies from 1 to n, here also 1 to n. So if n cells of even EMF E1 to En, resistances are from Rn, internal resistance, they are connected in series to form a row, and we have m such row. So if we have one row, like if we have certain n rows, there are n here, and we have from this point to this point, we have m such rows, they are connected in parallel, these are in series, n are in series, and we have m such rows, these are in series. So we have m such rows. If this kind of connection is there, this is a mixed combination, then I will be equivalent to sigma, this EI, R plus 1 by M, sigma RI. This capital R is the external resistance across this mixed form of connection, because we have series also, this series, and these series, they are in parallel. So they are number of parallel lines like this. So what will be the equivalent? Equivalent, the current passing through will be this value. M is the number of rows, N is the number of cells in a row. And of course, R is the external resistance which is connected to the mixed connection. In the circuit which is shown here, E1 is equal to 3 volt, E2 is equal to 2 volt, and E3 is 1 volt. The resistance R1, R2, R3, they are 1 ohm. Find the current through each branch and potential difference between the point A and B. So in this case, let us assume that this I is I is passing through, from A to B is passing through. Now I1, I2 and I3, this I1, see the directions are like this. I1 is this current, I2 is this current and I3 is this current. Okay. From the Kirchhoff law, if you take this point, I1 will be equal to I2 plus I3. Okay. And the I1, I2, I3 are there. Resistances are R1, R2 and R3. Now, first we have applied a junction rule. Kirchhoff first rule to junction A. This junction A says that the current is going from this, at this point current is coming here. The one current is coming and two currents are leaving. So I1 will be equal to I2 plus I3. This is our first equation. Now we'll apply the Kirchhoff's second rule to loops. First we'll take the loop as A and then B. You can take B and C and D, and then you can take E and F and A. So complete one we are taking, right? So if we take I1, R1, we are moving in this direction. So there will be, or you can say, let us move in ABC direction. So let us move in this direction. So now we are in opposite direction. So there will be a I1, R1 addition. Then because this is positive to negative, there is a drop, but the drop will be taken as minus E1. And then we are coming here, it is increasing. So minus to positive will be positive. And once you are in the opposite direction, you have to add it, right? And you can just rearrange and you will get this one. But we can take one more loop, which is A, B, C, D, E, F, A. A, B, C, D, A, you can take A, B, C, D, A. This whole you can take one and this whole you can take, right? So from both these, we get the second one, I1, R1 minus, because now E1 and E3 are coming. So E1 and E3 was this one, which I explained you. Now E1 and E2 you can also take. It will be similar. I1, R1, then E1, because the voltage is dropping. And then it is increasing, so E2. And then there is an increment of I2, R2, because you are in the opposite direction. So it will be like this. So when we combine these two equations, this E1 minus R1 will be equal to E2 plus IR2 will be equal to E3 plus IR3. And we know that I1 was equal to I2 plus I3. This was our first junction equation. So after this 3 and 4, if you see E1 minus in this I1, you can write I2 plus I3. So we have placed I2 plus I3 here and this remains here. So you get 2I3 plus I2 equal to 2. Also, we can use this to second equation. So you get E2 plus I2 R2 equal to E3 plus I3 R3. And you can just say rearranging this, you get I3 minus I2 equal to 1. So you have one this equation, second this equation. So and one more equation like this. So you can just solve I1, I2 and I3. I1 is 1 ampere, I2 is 0 ampere, I3 is 1 ampere, right? This is how we can find out the current. Now potential difference between A and B will be what? The potential difference between A and B is simply potential difference between A and D. These are same, right? So the potential difference between A and D is given by, this is, see, E1 minus I1 R1. We are taking this path. So E1 minus I R1, you can take this also. No worries about that. You can take this also. Any of these you can take. E1 minus I1 R1, so E1 is 3. I1 we just found out as 1 ampere and R1 this resistance is 1. So this is 2 volt. Wheatstone bridge. In 1843, Charles Wheatstone, he developed a circuit in order to measure unknown resistance and with a reference to standard known resistor. So we have a standard known resistance. With respect to that, he was able to know the value of an unknown resistor, and this circuit was known as Wheatstone bridge. So this Wheatstone bridge network is like this. The bridge has four resistor arms. This is R1, R2, R3 and R4, and they are forming a closed loop. The source of EMF is connected to A. See, this is the EMF source. It is connected to A, which is common point of R1 and R3, and C, which is common point of R2 and R4, right? And there is a sensitive galvanometer in between here. there is a galvanometer which is connected to point B and D. Okay, and B is the common point. B is the common point of R1 and R2, and D is the common point of this R3 and R4. So three resistors out of four are known, and fourth one is unknown, right? So the three resistors are chosen in such a way that the galvanometer shows zero reflection right now. So in this condition, the potential at point B and D are same because there is no movement of the galvanometer, there is no flow of current. So this condition of Wheatstone bridge is a balanced condition right now. So when we apply the Kirchhoff rule, we can take loop like AB, DA. So we are taking A, B, and then D and A. So what we will do here is, we are moving in the current direction, I1 into R1, there will be a drop. Then we are coming to this side, there will be an addition. The current is going like this, then there will be I2 into R2, because we are moving in the opposite direction. So it will be addition. So I1, R1 equal to I2, R3. Now we'll take B, C, D, A, B, C, D, B, B, C, D, and B. So when we are taking B, C, D, B, we are moving in the direction of the current. So there will be a voltage drop because of R2. So minus I1, R2, minus sign. Then we are moving in the opposite direction of current. So there will be plus I2, R4. So when we take this on the right hand side, I1, R2 will be equal to I2, R4. Now these two equations we will divide. So we get R1 by R2 equal to R3 by R4. And by knowing three resistors, if we know any three resistor, fourth can be easily found out. Meter bridge. This is a very simple practical device which is based on a Wheatstone bridge. And this is also known to know or to find out the resistance experimentally. And this is what is an example of meter bridge generally used in laboratory. So meter bridge consists of a constant 10 wire of length 1 meter. There is a wire of length 1 meter and a uniform cross section area which is used in place of resistor R3 and R4. We have resistor because in Wheatstone bridge we have R1, R2, R3, R4. But here in place of R3, R4 we are taking a uniform cross section area, right? Length of wire, 1 meter length of wire. Okay. This wire is stretched taut very fine and clamped to on a meter scale, which is mounted on a wooden platform. And there are two thick copper strips which are bent at right angles. These are bent at right angles. They are connected at two ends, this end and this end, A and C, this end and this end of the wire. The connecting terminals are provided on this metallic strip at the end point of the wire when the battery is connected. So when the battery is connected, there is a point through which it can be connected. So another copper strip is fixed between two thick copper strip in such a way that the metallic strip has two gaps. This has two gaps. It has two gaps across which the resistor can be connected. So R1 and R2 are connected here. One end of the sensitive galvanometer is connected to the copper strip midway. Here copper strip midway means this is the copper strip midway at a point B. Say this point is B, and between the two gaps. Okay. The other end of the galvanometer is connected to this point D, which is called a jockey, which can slide over the wire to make electric connection. So you can just slide it over, and this was the wire we were talking about, 1 meter wire. So as you see here in this figure, unknown resistance will, I'll show you the formation of this also. So here the unknown resistance, which is R1, is connected across one of the gaps, and a standard known resistor, which is R2, is connected across the other gap. So these were two gaps. This is unknown, this is known. So let one of the known resistor, which is our R2, the jockey is slided along this wire. This galvanometer jockey, which is connecting to this wire, is moved. Say it is moved to point D, where the galvanometer will show no current. That means R1, R2, and these two points, which were previously in Wheatstone bridge, it was R3 and R4, they are balanced. Point D is called the balance or null point. So now let the distance of the jockey from say point A, at the balance point, this AD is L1. From here to here, it is L1. And length of the wire DC is from here to here, it is L2. So now we know that R1 by R2, this R1 by R2 is given by the resistance of wire which is AD and resistance of wire which is DC. So we know that R equal to rho L upon A. We can use this. So R1 by R2 is simply given by L1 rho and L2 rho. Rho, because this is the same wire, so rho remains the same. So R1 by R2 is equivalent or is in proportion to the length L1 and L2. This R1 by R2 will be equivalent to this L1 by L2. Rho is the resistance per unit length of the wire. So if we have known that it is 1 meter, so one is, if L1 is L1, then the other will be 100 centimeter. If you take, it will be 100 minus L1. So L2 will be 100 minus L1. So we can easily find out R1 taking R2 here. This will be R1 equal to R2 L1 by 100 minus L1. And we can just choose various values of this resistance R2, the value of L1 and L2. We can calculate each time an average value of unknown resistance, which is our R1. So this method is accurate, quite accurate, and this method gives accurate value of unknown resistance R1, but the method is not useful for the measurement of very small resistances. Calculate the current through the BC wire from this circuit shown. So this is B and this is C. So we have to find out current through BC wire. So this Kirchhoff law easily can be used, right? We'll just redraw this circuit in different way. This, the four points, which is A, B, and C and D, these are common to two different resistances. We'll start with A. At point A, one end of the resistance 1 and 4. See, this one resistance, one number resistance, and four number resistance, these two are connected to A. Okay. A 100 ohm resistance is connected between B and C. Resistance 200 is connected between C and D. So our 200 resistance present between this B and D, which is this one, B and D, which is this one, sorry, this one, B and D, is resistance 5. So we can just, knowing the points between which these resistances are, we can just rearrange it, right? We can rearrange it because A point is this. We have 100 and this 100. So 100 is connected. Now this B and point C, there is internal 100, and there's this 200 and 200. These, because D has is a common point for 200, 200, so 200, 200 will be there. So this is the actual formation. Okay. So now in this circuit, a 10 volt battery is connected. This is a 10 volt battery between this point A and D, as you see here. So we have formed a closed loop when we go from A to B to D and C and back to A. So it's a loop. So a battery is connected between this A and D, which is 10 volt. Under this balanced condition, this is a Wheatstone bridge. Okay, no current will flow from B to C. There will be no current because this is a balanced situation, and we know that R1, this, why this is not, current is not passing, because R1 by R2, 100 by 100 will be equal to 200 by 200, okay? R1 by R2 will be equal to R4 by R3. So 100 by 200 is equal to 100 by 200. So this is equal, right? So no current will flow between B and C because this is a Wheatstone bridge, and in Wheatstone bridge we know, if the ratio of these two and the ratio of these two are equivalent, then there is no current which is passing through here. So there will be no current here. ohm resistor is connected to one of the gaps of meter bridge. Series combination of X ohm and 50 ohm resistors is connected in the second gap. Here unknown resistance X ohm is kept in a heat bath at certain temperature. Calculate the unknown resistance and its temperature if the balance point is obtained at 50 centimeter. The total length of the wire of the meter bridge is 1 meter. The resistance of the unknown resistor at 0 degree temperature is equal to 100 ohm. Alpha is given 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3. for the material of the X ohm resistor. Here we just have to use one thing, because it's a meter bridge, the resistance 1 by resistance 2 will be equal to L1 by L2. Okay. So resistance 1 is given as 200. Resistance 2, one is 50, one is X. So we will just add them, 50 plus X. L1, L2, because it is 50, it is balanced. So 50 by 50. Okay. R1 is 200, right? R2 is X plus 50. And L1 by L2, because one is 50, so the other will be 100 minus 50. That is 50. So we get X from here as 150 ohm. Now we know our equation, which is X is equal to X naught 1 plus alpha theta minus 0. This is at 0 degree. So 1 is theta, other is 0 degree. So this X is 150, which we just found. X0 was 100 as given in the question, right? It is 100, which is 100 ohm. 1 plus 5, this is alpha, theta minus 0 is theta. So we have to find out theta. Theta comes to be 100 degree centigrade. So this is one more part of the current electricity topic. We'll be taking few more. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.